Where is the point that, according to our recent scenarios, the latest scenarios, it may be that global warming will exceed more than 8 degrees warming, centigrades, not Fahrenheit, after 2200. That is a not very likely scenario, but it's a consistent scenario, actually. And that would actually push humanity to the physiological limits. It would simply mean that individuals in certain regions could not survive under that heat stress, so we would have to migrate. And it's clear that since this is a medical congress here, it's actually the World Health Summit, I mean, every doctor tells you, even my doctor tells me, that it is prevention which is better than therapy. Prevention really means do not allow that global warming will exceed moderate levels, like 2 or 3 degrees, where we all think we can still cope with. If we let it go unabated, it will overstretch all public health systems. It will be a multifactorial challenge, actually. So we will have very simple problems, like certain regions will become increasingly uninhabitable, so to speak, because of saltwater intrusion, sea level rise, heat waves, droughts, of course. I mean, the predictions of the weather and climate models are that it will become even drier in the already dry regions, and it will become wetter in the regions which are already wet. So it's precisely the thing which you do not like to have. You will have heat stress, of course, physiological reactions. You will have many more hot summer days in Europe, for example, in particular on the Iberian Peninsula. But the big unknown, the big question mark really is how the pattern of infectious diseases in a globalized world will be impacted by climate change. And this is a huge research agenda.